Hi guys, it's Summer. Today's video is gonna be a really short 5 tips to ensure you get accepted into the DCP in 5 minutes. These tips are things I found, I think, really set me over the edge and gave me a bit of a curve on all the competition and gave me a little bit of an edge when going through different parts of the application process. So I'm here today to share those tips with you really quickly, not make this a long video, so you can just boom, 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 get these things down, and I hope they really help you out. Recently, I was accepted into the DCP Fall 2018 program. If you guys are interested, I will link my interview right here in the little information icon. I think that's kind of all the housework I needed to do, so let's go ahead and get on with the tips. Tip number one is apply right off the bat. If you guys have watched my interview, or maybe if you haven't, I'll let you know that at the very end, I asked what are some good things that I did in this interview that I could use and take in future interviews. My interviewer was so great. She did give me a lot of feedback, which I wasn't expecting Disney to really give me, but they did. I'm glad I had the, you know, guts to ask that kind of question. One of the things she mentioned to me was applying right off the bat. Usually when the apps drop, people will apply when they get the email, which is actually a day after applications come out. I made sure I knew the exact day the applications dropped, already had my resume ready to go, and submitted it the night of, and within 15 minutes was offered a web-based interview. Disney does not waste time, so applying right off the bat and getting a head start is the best thing you can do. Tip number two, completing your web-based interview quickly ensures you an early phone interview. The web-based interview is pretty self-explanatory. There are a lot of videos on that and a lot of tips. As long as you're yourself in the web-based interview, you should get a phone interview. As I said in the first tip, being quick and getting things done quickly is gonna get you the best advantage in this application. Once you see you've got your web-based interview, don't hesitate. Go ahead, try to set aside 30 to 45 minutes and take that thing, and you're gonna nail it. As soon as you successfully complete your web-based interview and are offered a phone interview position, you pick your phone interview date, like, right afterward. Again, this gets you a leg up in the competition and just a sooner phone interview. Tip number three has to do with the phone interview portion. Don't use generic answers. A lot of times in the phone interview, people use very overused answers. So if it was a question such as, "Have you ever lived with a roommate and had conflict?" The majority of the time people are gonna answer, "Yes, and we had a conflict, here's the small conflict, we worked it out." You have to understand that these people, the interviewers, are doing tons of phone interviews a day and they've heard this story before. Setting yourself apart in the competition is super easy, probably a lot easier than you think. You just need to be unique and think about your answers before your actual phone interview. Tip number four is also for your phone interview. Tell stories. I personally did this in my interview and I think it really set me apart. I feel like at the end when I asked for feedback, Natalie, my interviewer, hey Natalie, after every story I told Natalie, she seemed to really like connect with me. More so than my PI being an interview, it was more of a conversation I had with her, and I think that really helped. And by telling stories, it gave me more of an edge than just the generic. So here in my video, I'm gonna give a couple clips of about 3 or 4 stories I kind of told so you can get an idea. I had the great opportunity to work 5 weeks of summer camp. One of the problems we faced was one of the girls found a bed bug. I made sure that the girl's information was kept quiet. I went and got the camp counselors who had the authority to take care of that, that a certain coupon only applied to certain items in the store. And I had an older lady come in who, she's one of my favorite customers now. Her name is Sue. Summer, I've tried every combination. I cannot get this coupon to work. So she came back. I was able to use the coupon on the transaction. Make sure these stories are super unique so that they kind of stick and it's like, wow, like, she actually did have a really good experience, or wow, she really is well-rounded. Tip number five, in your phone interview, if you are looking to get a specific role, for instance, if you really would like to work character attendant, use verbs that show you have the qualities to be a character attendant. For instance, if I wanted to be a character attendant, I may say something like, "I'm very good at multitasking." You could also say, "I'm very good with crowd control." You could talk about your storytelling abilities and talk about how, if you were a character attendant, here's what I would do. I would get down on the child's level and get them so excited to see Winnie the Pooh and things like that. If you would like to be a photo pass photographer or maybe even do custodial, talk about how you love doing individual work and how you work better as an individual as opposed to a team. By using verbs like this, you highlight the really good qualities of yourself that are suited for that position. Saying things like you're always on time and you're a hard worker are great qualities, but if you really want to kind of hone in on a certain like position you want, make sure you use those really good verbs. And I have a really quick bonus tip for you guys. Do not be afraid to show you love Disney. One of the things Natalie mentioned to me after my interview and the feedback was how much it stood out about how passionate I was for Disney and about how long I had been passionate for Disney. In my interview, I spoke about how I had been interested in the DCP since middle school, and I also talked about how at current jobs I've had or jobs in the past that I've had, how I try to implement the characteristics an actual cast member would have. So don't act like this is just another internship. If you love Disney, which I know a lot of you guys do, because when you post your phone interview videos, you've got the ears on, or you've got Mickey in the back or something like that. Do not be afraid to talk about it. Make sure you talk about how you've gone to the Disney parks and how you just fell in love and your favorite aspect, whether it's the rides or whether it's even if you want to be a vacation planner, talk about how your vacation planner was awesome and that's what made you love Disney. Like, really be unique with your answers because it stands out, you guys. That is all for today, you guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you have a magical day. If you're interested in following along on my journey where I post more about the DCP and the process I'm going through right now, you can follow my Instagram linked here. If any of you guys are going to the Ann Arbor, Michigan character auditions on March 4th, let me know because that is where I'm going to be at. More videos to come soon. Thank you for all of your support, all the messages I've received, and I will talk to you guys soon.